So what parameters specifically define the transition from acute to chronic pain has been a question that's been in the field for the last 50 years. This is an effort of trying to find, when you follow a group of patients who all start with an acute back pain episode, who are all at the beginning equated as to the amount of pain, the duration of pain, the intensity of pain, and in fact are equal both in anxiety and depression across a whole spectrum of characteristics. And we follow them over a whole year, we find out that 50% of them are still have exactly the same pain that they started with. So these are the patients who are becoming chronic in a sense. And the other 50%, their pain essentially goes down to levels that are clinically not significant anymore. So those are the patients who are recovering. And so when we look at their brain white matter properties, they're completely different. And the difference, in fact, again, 80, 90 to 100% predicts who is becoming a chronic pain patient versus not. If we understand these things in more detail, these different types of chronic pain conditions, each one, its graphical, architectural, structural signatures, those things would give us clues as to what kind of drugs we need to use to cure them. And that's really what we're after. We want